Okay. So, hi sir.
Hello.
Please tell us something about Ashden Awards.
Yeah, Ashden Awards is run since 2001 from UK. It's an international award in renewable energy, in sustainable mobility, in sustainable buildings. It's given every year. The awardee gets £20,000. And so far, there are 240 award winners all over the world. And in India, we have 30 of them, which is the highest concentration in any geography.
Okay. How does Ashden support the winners? And what else does the organization do in its selected areas?
The Ashden Awards, they select winners through a very rigorous competition. Once they the award is given, one is the prestige of that organization that increases. So more people start trusting that organization. The second part is the financial part, which they get a support for further development up to £20,000. The third is that the award winners are linked with different agencies who can take their work further, like financial agencies or investors. So it helps them greatly to kind of leverage their awards to for their future growth.
Okay, fine. How big is your work in India overall?
Yeah, so what we had done in 2014 was that since we had a large concentration of award winners in India, we started a collective, like an association of all the award winners, which is a separate organization than Ashden UK. So once the award is given by the Ashden UK, the award winner becomes a member of the Ashden India Collective. And then we provide some support in form of networking between the award winners, and then networking with different other agencies who can, these people can influence, or the agencies could help them.
Is this the focus on working with the government or related agencies, or do you work with other entities too?
We what is special about the collective or the award winners is that all of them are practitioners.
Okay.
And most of them are located in deep rural areas of India. They have brought a solution. Mm. So their knowledge and experience is something which is proven on the ground.
Okay.
So when we bring them from their fields and collect them around the table where the government agencies are also there, the conviction of that knowledge is much more stronger than theoretical knowledge.
Means practically you want to...
Yeah, so practically they have done something, so which helps then the government to design their programs in a way to get a positive feedback from the different award winners in their sector. So that is a difference between any other consultancy or knowledge organization and us. Plus, we are now expanding to the corporate social responsibility space, the CSR space, that where we would like to help building knowledge of those funds so that they can do a better impact in clean energy space in their areas of work. And possibly taking help from the collective members, or taking knowledge from them and replicating somewhere else.
Okay, fine. What do you see as the biggest challenge for India in ensuring sustainable energy access for all?
What the biggest challenge at this moment is the fast growth of India. We have to grow fast. We can't stop that. At the same time, to sustain that growth, we have to start thinking about the impact of that growth much earlier. So to match the use of natural energy or clean systems and sustain the economic growth of the country, this is the biggest challenge at this point.
Thank you. Fine. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.